Okay, so what we're gonna do now with this tablet, we're gonna do a quick unboxing and a quick setup on this tablet. Right now I'm at my mom's house. It's during the nighttime, so let's get to it. All right, so now that the manuals are loose from this holder, that's right here, let's see what we have. First off, we have the quick start guide. Second, we have the health and safety guide. And third, we have the little support pamphlet from Samsung. So as you open it here, that's what it says. You can pause the video if you'd like. All right. Let's whip all this together here. And this. So those are the accessories that you see inside the box. And without further ado, let's jump on the tablet, which is the main thing on this video. So here we are looking at the tablet. As beautiful and as glorious as it can look while it's inside the wrapper. Here we have the name and the model of it right on the wrapper itself. I don't know what material this is, whether if it's cloth or whatever kind of paper or thin paper that they use. God knows what it is. If any of you know about it, please drop it down in the comments. I'm curious to know what kind of material is this wrapper. So that's how she looks. So I'm gonna pop it out. And probably the easiest way for me to do this, since I'm working on a bed, I might as well just, yeah. Right. So this is how the tablet looks like, all fully unwrapped. And that glass is looking good and it's shining good. Look at that. All right. That is probably until I turn it and I start getting my fingerprints on it. So maybe this will probably be the last to be seen, as it looks all new. As the glass is allowing the light to shine on it. So yeah. So that's the camera and the sensor here in the front. And right over here we have the home button, back button, and multiple application buttons right there. So let's turn it to the back. We have the camera. I don't see any sensors just like they would on the phone, but and of course that's all that's right there. Now over here, towards the right side of the tablet, you could see the power button and the volume buttons right there. Next, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go right into the setup of this tablet. So let's power it on and let's see what this tablet will do once it'll greet me. And also, those of you who are watching, let's see how this thing is going to greet us for the first time. So let's power it on. Now, I'm not going to keep this video on too long because, of course, the setup is going to take a while to do, and it's going to get a few of you bored as well. So I'm going to try to do as best as I can just to try to set up all the accounts that need to be necessarily set up on this tablet, and then I'll meet you up on the other side when possible. All right, so I'll be right back. So here we are back again. The setup is complete. It took no longer than 15 minutes to get this thing all set up. As you can see, it looks really good. Now, here's the one thing that annoys me about Samsung and their setups. Now, I'm sure every tablet is different, but I didn't see this on mine. They should at least give you the right to choose whether if you want to restore stuff from your older devices. A right if you want to or not. I think they should always give you that option. Because sometimes when you have a new device, sometimes there are people that want to restore stuff from their older devices. There are others that don't. Like in my case, I have two devices under the same email account, and I sure just don't want to restore the stuff from the other device onto this one. Samsung, I think you should work on that. Now, I want to show you some cool things on this tablet. Just two cool things, and then we should end this video. I'll be right back. Alright, the first cool feature I'd like to show you is a fingerprint on this tablet. The fingerprint scanner on the home key. So here we go. I had to get used to this myself because... And let's see how I could do this with just one hand. Let's see. So you power it on. And when you do this, you gotta make sure the finger that you use covers the entire home key. So here we go. There we go, and we're in. And now, for the second cool feature. Okay, now this feature is the screen capture on the tablet. So let's see how I can do this with just one hand. So, what Samsung would normally suggest, see if I could stick it right here under the light. And let's see if I could do this with just one hand. So see, here you go. Nope. So let's put the camera on over here. And let's see if I can do it this way. See that? Let's try it again. There we go. So that is how you do the screenshot capture on this. So if you go to gallery, and as you can see right over here, these are the screenshots that I just did, just using my hands. All right. So when it comes to the quick setup of this tablet, the Samsung Galaxy Tab S2, it's pretty simple, straightforward. And like I mentioned on this video, some of the stuff can be kind of annoying when you want to set up your second device in a different way than what you have your first. In this case, this is how I have it. I have two devices now under the same account. But then again, I just don't want to put the stuff from my old device onto this device. I just want to set it up a little differently. So Samsung, I think you should be able to work on just providing that option for future devices. All right, so this is 270 EHA 19, simply saying thank you for watching.